Friends and dear students, today I am going to speak on a very important subtopic or aspect in introduction to environmental economics. All of us know for each and every activity, productive resources are required, and those are prominently classified into human resources, natural or environmental resources, and physical resources. Natural or environmental resources are very scarce, and therefore, because of their scarcity, there is a need for their preservation, conservation, and protection as well. And their optimal allocation and utilization rationally is also of crucial importance. In this backdrop, there is need for discussing natural or environmental resources and their various components. One of the categories of natural resources based on property rights, that is common property resources. And today in this lecture, we are going to study what is common property resources, what are its features, what trend is there, what is importance, and how it is useful so far as the growth and development of the economy in general and welfare of the society as a whole in particular is concerned. And therefore, first of all, I will share my presentation, and with the help of presentation, I will try to explain how common property resources are of crucial importance and how those are very much necessary in studying introduction to economics of environment. First of all, common property resources is a classification of the resources in general, and natural resources in particular is based on the property right. What is property right? Property right is an institutional system in which ownership and management of the resources is identified and specified. That is, different resources are there, either their ownership or right to use or manage those resources is identified by that institution or institutional mechanism. That institutional system or mechanism is known as property right. There are different forms of property right: private property right, public property right, state property right, open access property right, common property right. Private means personal or individual. Public means all the people in the society as a whole. State means government ownership or right over the resource. Open access means everybody can get benefit of that resource. And common property right, a group of people, a community, that right is given, and that right is known as common property right. Thus, the forms of property right comprise of private property right, public property right, state, open access, and common property right. Based on the property rights or forms of the property rights, the resources or commodities and services are classified into different categories or types. Number one is private resources or goods. Number two, public resources or goods. Number three, state resources or goods. Number four, open resources or goods. And last, common property resources and goods. Private resources and goods mean the ownership or right of the resources and goods is given to a particular person or individual. Public means all people have a right to use that resource or goods. State means government is the owner of those resources and goods. Open access, everybody has a right to derive benefit of that resource or those goods, is known as open access or resources goods. And common property resources means a group of people, a community of people, to which right is given to use that resource or that good is known as common property resources or goods. Here it is expected to study in detail common property resources. Its definition can be discussed. A property on which well-defined collective claims by an exclusive group are established. The use of the resource is subtractive, having the character of public good, such as indivisibility. That is, common property resources are the resources on which collective right is given, joint right is given to you, to a particular group of people or to a particular community. And that right is used the resource, and that the use of the resource is subtractive, that is deductible. And those resources have a characteristic of public good or public service, that of indivisibility. And indivisibility means the benefits of the common property resources cannot be divided into small parts, for those are indivisible. Another definition is resources which are either collectively owned or community has exclusive user right to those resources is known as common property resources. Thus, based on these definitions of common property resources, we are in a position to derive certain characteristics of common property resources. What can be those? Number one, a group or community has exclusive right to use those resources. Number two, use of resource is subtractive, that is deductive. Indivisibility benefits cannot be divided into small parts. Exclusion cannot be done. People cannot be excluded. Some people or group of people cannot be excluded. There can be rules, regulation within the group about allocation, utilization of the resources. Then there is a linkage between, there is a relationship between common property resources and private property resources. And the linkage reveals that there is a they are complementary. They are helping each other. They are complementary. And when the correlation was calculated, it was estimated. It was found that the coefficient of correlation was 0.8 means 80%. That is, there is high positive relationship between them. Now, basically, common property resources. When we talk about common property land resources predominantly, common property resources, especially land common property resources, are classified into forest common property land resources and non-forest common property land resources. And what's their availability? Just so as to get an idea what availability is there in India as well as in the state of Maharashtra, it is necessary to discuss. Now, the availability of total common land common property resources in India is 74,573,000 hectares. And in Maharashtra, 7,196,000 hectares. And when it is divided into non-forest common property resources and forest common property resources, we find that non-forest common property resources are 13,031,000 hectares, and forest common property resources are 25,712. That is, non-forest common property resources, when all categories of non-common forest resources are added in, taken into account, it comes at 48,461,000 hectares. And forest common property resources, that is 24,712, and the total is 74,573,000 hectares. That is, non-forest land resources are more than the forest common property land resources. Now, it is found that about 15% of the total geographical area are common land property resources. And per 1,000 availability is 0.31. Per capita common property land resource availability is 0.06. Now, there are components of common property land resources: community pastures and grazing land, 23%, village forest and woodlands, woodlots, 16%, and others, 61%. Now, when we see, it is found that there is a depleting trend. There is a depleting trend in the common property resources. Common property resources have been declining in India, in globe, as well as in the state of Maharashtra. Take example, reduction in common property land resources in last 5 years to per 1,000 hectare is 19 hectares, that is about 2%. And 2% reduction or decrease in the availability of land common property resources, really, it's a serious thing. It's a thing of serious concern. Now, why this is happening? Why common property land resources are depleting? Number of reasons are responsible. Number one is the use of land common property resources is not made improperly. It is not made properly. Why? No fees are there, no charges are there. Carelessness is there. No precaution is taken in using those resources commonly or rationally, optimally. People do not know, or they don't have any knowledge about right over the resources. No ownership is there. Just common ownership is there. And therefore, that makes a difference so far as preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources there. And exactly that is happening in India, in Maharashtra, as well as in the world or globe as a whole. And therefore, no ownership, exact ownership is there, just common ownership is there. And common ownership is there, nobody's ownership it is. And therefore, that is happening. Then people are estimating improperly, that is underestimation of value of the common land property resources or resources they take into. And therefore, when the value is more, people try to preserve them, conserve them, protect them. But if the value is lower, no care is taken, and underestimation has resulted in lower value of the common property resources, and consequently, their preservation, protection, conservation is not being undertaken. And as the result of that, the depletion in the common property resources is taking place. So people or society is not aware of, and it is not having knowledge of, common property resources can be productive. They have believed that they are unproductive. And consequently, when they are unproductive, they are neglected. No care is taken, no preservation, no protection, no conservation is even undertaken. And it is therefore unproductive approach towards the common property resources is resulting in what we call it as a misuse, underuse of the common property resources that is there. Then when nobody's owner, common ownership is there, no control over the common property resources is there. And as the result of the overuse, excessive use, irrational use, illogical use, unscientific use of the common property resources takes place. And that is happening in the country like us, in the state of Maharashtra, across the countries in the globe as a whole as well. And as the result of that, depletion in the common property resources, loss of the common property resources that is taking place. One more very important cause or factor responsible for common property resources is the role which the common property resources can play. They also can play a very important role in the growth and development of the economy. And basically, that has been neglected, that has been neglected. The utility of the common property resources has been neglected. And as a result of that, common property resources are, their depletion is taking place. Loss therein is taking place, and consequently their role, their importance in the development, in the growth is not being exploited, not being visualized, not being extracted. And that is taking place, that is happening. It is also one of the factors which is responsible. Now the question is, why common property resources are required? Why their preservation, conservation is necessary? already we have, in other words, we can, what is importance, what is the relevance of the common property resources? And already we have discussed on depletion or loss of common property resources that is taking place. So how it will impact, how it is impacting when depletion of the common property resources is taking place? That is also necessary to be examined, analyzed. It is necessary to be discussed. Number one, resource degradation. Common property resource is a natural resource. Land is there, pond is there, forest is there. These are the natural resources. And because of depletion, to that extent, resource degradation is taking place. And when resource degradation is taking place, their scarcity is intensified, number one. Number two, resources are very valuable economically. And when degradation takes place, that results in loss of economic value. And consequently, that is posing economic burden on the society as a whole, because it is economic loss. And economic loss, loss to the person, loss to the society, loss to the community, loss to the economy, loss to the nation as a whole. And that is happening. Then it is increasing scarcity of the resources. Take an example, grassland is there, forest land is there, village land is there, playgrounds are there, their scarcity, pond is there. Their scarcity is increasing. And that is increasing, it is because of depletion of the common property resources that is taking place very rapidly, very significantly, that is there. Supplement to that, when common property resources decrease, that results in environmental degradation, because forest is depleted, grassland is depleted, pond is depleted. That is environmental degradation, and that can be a cause for environmental imbalance, and it can be a hindrance in the environmental balance, ecological balance that is there. Supplementary to that, because of depletion in the common property resources that is taking place, to that extent, loss of income source, loss of livelihood, and loss of economic growth also taking place. And for that reason, it is one of the very important impacts of depletion in the common property resources that is taking place. Because of loss of income, livelihood loss is taking place, support to livelihood is taking place. And that is also one of the very important impacts, or we can say importance, of the preservation, conservation, protection, and growth in the common property resources is there. Then the further question is, what remedies, what are measures, what are policies? Those are helpful us, for us, in preservation, conservation, and protection of the common property resources. Number one is cultivation or shifting of cultivation. We should shift cultivation in agriculture. Shifting of cultivation can preserve, conserve grass, common land, common property resources. Grassland can be there, village land can be there, forest land can be there, and therefore shifting of cultivation is necessary. Number two, it is necessary to give rights over the common property resources. And when rights are given, some concessions, incentives, motivations are necessary to be given. As the result of that, they will preserve, conserve, and properly utilize the common property resources. And it is therefore rights and concessions are necessary to be given so far as preservation, conservation of the common property resources on the one hand, and their extracting of role in the growth and development of the society as well as welfare of the society as a whole. Then joint forest management, when we talk about the land common property resources in general and forest common property resources in particular, all of us know forest plays a very important role in preservation, conservation, protection of the environment, especially the problem like greenhouse effect, global warming, climate change, that can be arrested, that can be restricted because of the forest resource. And therefore, joint management of the forest can be carried out. Consequently, their preservation, conservation, protection will take place and growth will take place. And therefore, it is one of the measures suggested for restricting depletion in the common property resources that is taking place. Now, preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources should take a form of people's movement, because power of the people is very high level, it is very substantial. And therefore, when it takes a form of people's movement, people will wholeheartedly attempt for preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources. And therefore, it should take a form of people's movement in the preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources. That in that, no permission to cut the trees and no permission to graze the grassland should be given. That will preserve the land, common property resources in general, grassland in particular, and forest common property resources in exclusive. Then we can try for gobar gas plants, because waste is there, waste from forest is there, waste from animal is there, that can be used for gobar gas plants, that can generate power, that can generate energy, and that is eco-friendly. No pollution will take place, it will control greenhouse gas emission, then back to global warming, greenhouse effect, and climate change as well. Women's play can play a very important role in the preservation, conservation of the common property resources. And their clubs, their organizations can help us in preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources. So it is therefore in that direction the efforts will be made. As a result of that, through women's clubs, common property resources like grassland, like forest land, like village land, that can be preserved. Nature club like that of women's club, nature clubs of youth, of students, of teachers, of social activists can be formed, and they can help, they can play a role in preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources and restricting depletion in the resources that is taking place. Local government specifically can impose local taxes. Forest tax, grassland tax, quand tax, village land tax, mountain land tax, likewise. That will put economic burden over the people. And consequently, to avoid that burden, people will try for preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources, like land, like grassland, like forest land, like pond, like village land, etc. Then, in the community, in the group of people, rules and regulations should be prepared and implemented for allocation, utilization, preservation, conservation, growth in the common property resources that is there. That will help us in restricting rapid depletion in the common property resources that is taking place. And on the other hand, preservation, conservation, protection of the common property resources. And more importantly, that will help us in extracting and utilizing these common property resources in the growth and development of the economy, as well as social welfare of the society as a whole. As upon एक प्रकारच्या नैसर्गिक साधन सामग्रीच्या प्रकाराचा किंवा एका प्रकारचा अभ्यास किंवा विचार करत आहोत. आपल्याला माहित आहे की सर्वसाधारणपणे उत्पादन साधनांचं वर्गीकरण, संसाधनांचं वर्गीकरण तीन प्रकारांमध्ये केलं जातं. एक म्हणजे नैसर्गिक साधने, दोन मानवी साधने आणि तीन भौतिक साधने. आता ही जी नैसर्गिक साधने किंवा संसाधने आहेत त्यांचे काही वेगवेगळ्या निकषांच्या आधारे कसं त्यांच्या आधारे वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारांमध्ये वेगवेगळ्या गटांमध्ये त्याचं वर्गीकरण केलं जातं. अशाच प्रकारचा एक नैसर्गिक संसाधनाचा प्रकार असं आपल्याला म्हणता येईल, त्याला आपण सामुदायिक मालकी साधने असं आपण म्हणतो. आता हे जे वर्गीकरण आहे, हा जो प्रकार आहे तो जो संपदा अधिकार आहे, मालकी हक्क आहे, प्रॉपर्टी राईट आहे, त्याच्यावरती आधार आहे. आपण सुरुवातच मग संपदा अधिकार किंवा मालकी हक्क यापासून करूया. संपदा अधिकार किंवा मालकी हक्क म्हणजे काय? अशी एक संस्थात्मक संस्था, संस्थात्मक व्यवस्था की जी संसाधनाची मालकी किंवा वापराचं व्यवस्थापन, व्यवस्थापनाचा अधिकार देते, निश्चित करते, त्याला संपदा अधिकार किंवा मालकी हक्क असं म्हणतात. त्याचे सर्वसाधारणपणे खाजगी हक्क, सार्वजनिक हक्क, सरकारी हक्क, मुक्त हक्क आणि सामुदायिक मालकी हक्क अशा प्रकारचं वर्गीकरण केलं जातं. खाजगी हक्क म्हणजे व्यक्तीला किंवा एखाद्या कुटुंबाला अधिकार दिला जातो. सार्वजनिक म्हणजे सगळ्यांना हक्क दिला जातो. स्टेट सरकारी म्हणजे सरकार मालक असतो. ओपन ॲक्सेस म्हणजे प्रत्येकाला त्या संसाधनाच्या वापराचा अधिकार, त्याचा लाभ घेण्याचा हक्क असतो. आणि सामुदायिक म्हणजे एका समाजाची, लोकांच्या गटाची, एका समुदायाची मालकी असणे, याला आपण सामुदायिक मालकी हक्क असं म्हणतो. यावरती आधारित संसाधनांचे किंवा वस्तूंचं वर्गीकरण खाजगी संसाधने आणि वस्तू, सार्वजनिक संसाधने आणि वस्तू, सरकारी संसाधने किंवा साधने आणि वस्तू, आणि खुला किंवा मुक्त वापर संसाधने आणि वस्तू, आणि सामुदायिक मालकी संसाधने आणि वस्तू अशा पद्धतीने केला जातो. म्हणजे एखाद्या व्यक्तीला, एखाद्या कुटुंबाला साधने वापरण्याचा, वस्तू वापरण्याचा अधिकार, सर्व लोकांना साधने आणि वस्तू वापरण्याचा अधिकार म्हणजे सार्वजनिक साधने आणि वस्तू. किंवा सरकारच मालक असतं त्या साधनांचा आणि वस्तूंचा, त्याला आपण सरकारी मालकीची साधने आणि वस्तू म्हणतो. सर्वांना संसाधनांचा आणि वस्तूंचा वापर करण्याचा, लाभ घेण्याचा अधिकार असतो. किंवा मुक्त प्रवेश साधने, मुक्त वापर साधने आणि वस्तू असं म्हणतो. आणि जेव्हा संसाधनांवर, वस्तूंवर, साधनांवर एखाद्या समुदायाची, लोकांच्या गटाची, एखाद्या समूहाची मालकी असते, तेव्हा त्याला आपण सामुदायिक मालकी साधने असं म्हणतो. त्याची एक व्याख्या दिलेली आहे. व्याख्यांच्या आधारे या सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांचा अर्थ समजावून घेण्याचा प्रयत्न करू. सामुदायिक मालकी साधने म्हणजे असा अधिकार, असा हक्क की जो एखाद्या गटाला किंवा एखाद्या समुदायाला दिला जातो आणि त्याचा, त्याच्या वापराचा अधिकार दिल्यानंतर, तो वापर केल्यानंतर हळूहळू त्याची उपलब्धता कमी होते. त्याचं स्वरूप जवळपास सार्वजनिक वस्तूसारखं असतं की ज्यामध्ये अविभाज्यता यासारखं गुणधर्म, यासारखं वैशिष्ट्य असतं. अशा साधनांना, संसाधनांना सामुदायिक मालकी साधने असं आपण म्हणतो. जेव्हा एखादी व्यक्ती, एखादं कुटुंब किंवा एखादा समूह, एखादा गट किंवा एखादा समुदाय याला साधनांच्या मालकीचा अधिकार दिला जातो, तेव्हा त्याला आपण सामुदायिक मालकी साधने असं आपण म्हणतो. याची वैशिष्ट्य काय? तर एखाद्या समुदायाला किंवा लोकांच्या गटाला तो अधिकार असतो. जसजसा आपण वापर करत जाऊ साधनांचा, तस तसा उपलब्धता कमी कमी होत जाते. लाभाची अविभाज्यता म्हणजे लाभाचं छोट्या छोट्या भागांमध्ये विभाजन किंवा वाटप करता येत नाही. वर्जन तत्व लागू पडत नाही, म्हणजे कुणाला वगळता येत नाही. नियम त्या गटामध्ये नियम किंवा नियमावली असू शकते वापराच्या संदर्भातली. याचे उदाहरण काय? तर याचे उदाहरण तलाव आहे, गवताचं कुरण आहे, गावठाण जमीन आहे, जंगल आहे, गावठाण किंवा खेड्यातील जंगल मैदान आहे, ही त्याची उदाहरणं म्हणून आपल्याला सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांची सांगता येईल. आता ही जी सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं आहेत आणि खाजगी मालकी साधनं आहेत, यामध्ये कसा संबंध आहे? ती एकमेकाला विरोध आहेत का पूरक आहे? याचा जेव्हा आकडेवारीच्या आधारे अभ्यास केला गेला, त्यावेळेला असं लक्षात आलं की खाजगी मालकी साधने आणि सामुदायिक मालकी साधने परस्पर पूरक आहे. त्यांच्यामध्ये समसंबंध आहे, त्यांच्यामध्ये पूरकता आहे. आणि त्याचं जेव्हा को रिलेशन मोजण्यात आलं, तेव्हा को रिलेशन, ज्याला आपण को रिलेशन गुणांक असं म्हणतो, सहसंबंध गुणांक, त्याला आर असं म्हणतो, तो 0.8 म्हणजे 80% आला. म्हणजे त्यांच्यामध्ये धन आणि उच्च पातळीवरचा संबंध आहे हे लक्षात आलं. आता ही जी सामुदायिक मालकी साधन आहे, त्यामध्ये तलाव आहे, यामध्ये गावठाण जमीन आहे, यामध्ये गवताचं कोरण आहे, यामध्ये वन आहे, जंगल आहे, याचा जर आपण विचार केला तर यातला आपण फक्त जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं आपण बघितली तर त्याची उपलब्धता काय आहे हे आपल्याला लक्षात येईल. प्रथमतः जमीन मालकी साधनांची उपलब्धता आपल्या देशामध्ये 74,573,000 हेक्टर्स एवढे आणि महाराष्ट्रामध्ये 7,196,000 हेक्टर्स आहे. त्याचं वर्गीकरण ढोबळमानानं बिगर जंगल सामुदायिक जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधने, जंगल किंवा वन सामुदायिक मालकी साधने असं केलं जातं. जंगल किंवा वन सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांची भारतामध्ये उपलब्धता किती आहे? तर ते 25,712 हजार हेक्टर्स, आणि महाराष्ट्रामध्ये त्याची उपलब्धता किती आहे? तर 1,546 हजार हेक्टर्स. बिगर जंगल सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांची उपलब्धता देशामध्ये किती आहे? 48,461 हजार हेक्टर्स, आणि महाराष्ट्रामध्ये 5,750 हजार हेक्टर्स. म्हणजे बिगर जंगल सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांची उपलब्धता जंगल सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांपेक्षा अधिक आहे. साधारणतः एकूण भौगोलिक क्षेत्राच्या 15% एवढी जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधन आहे, आणि त्याची उपलब्धता तर बघितली, जर आपण दर 1,000 कुटुंबांना त्याची उपलब्धता बघितली तर ती 0.31 हेक्टर एवढी आहे. आणि दरडोई जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधनाची उपलब्धता बघितली तर ती साधारणतः 0.06 हेक्टर एवढी आहे. त्याचं वर्गीकरण ढोपळ म्हणा, गवताचं कोरण 23%, त्यानंतर खेड्यातलं वन किंवा गावती जंगल असं आपण म्हणतो 16%, आणि इतर जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधने 61%. आता एक आपल्याला अशी प्रवृत्ती दिसते की हे जे सामुदायिक मालकी साधन आहेत किंवा जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधन आहेत त्यांच्यामध्ये वेगानं घट होत आहे. एकच थोडस आकडेवारी आपण सांगितली तर गेल्या 5 वर्षामध्ये दर 1,000 हेक्टरला 19 हेक्टर एवढं उपलब्धता कमी झाली आहे. त्याची टक्केवारी किती आहे? 2%. प्रतिवर्ष 2% जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधन नष्ट होणं, कमी होणं, म्हणजे हे वाईट आहे किंवा ते तीव्र आहे असं आपल्याला म्हणतात. मग त्याची कारणं काय असू शकतात? त्याची कारणं आहेत की सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांचा योग्य वापर होत नाही, चुकीचा वापर होतो, अपुरा वापर होतो, कारण त्यासाठी शुल्क किंवा किंमत काय द्यावी लागत नाही, त्यांच्यावरती कुणाची मालकी नाही, सगळ्या सामुदायिक मालकी म्हणजे सगळ्यांची मालकी, सामुदायिक मालकी म्हणजे कोणाचीच मालकी नाही, आणि त्यामुळं त्याचं संरक्षण संवर्धन करण्याचा प्रयत्न हा संबंधितांकडून केला जात नाही. सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांचं जे मूल्य आहे, त्याचं जे महत्त्व आहे, त्याचं योग्य मापन होत नाही, अपूर्ण मापन होतं, आणि मग काय किरकोळ आहे म्हणून त्याकडे दुर्लक्ष केलं जातं. त्यामुळं सुद्धा ही जी सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं आहेत ती सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं संपत चाललेले, नष्ट होत चाललेले असं दिसतं. सामुदायिक मालक साधनं उत्पादक आहेत यावर विश्वासच बसत नाही, ते अनुत्पादक आहेत असं वाटतं लोकांना, संबंधितांना, त्यामुळं त्यांचं संरक्षण संवर्धन करण्याचा प्रयत्न हा लोकांकडून केला जात नाही किंवा होत नाही, ते कारण आहे. त्यानंतर त्याच्या वापरावरती कुणाचं नियंत्रण नाही, कारण सामुदायिक मालकी म्हणजे कोणाचीच मालकी नाही, आणि त्यामुळं सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांच्या वापरावरती नियंत्रण नसल्यामुळं मोठ्या प्रमाणावरती घट होत चालली आहे. सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं महत्त्वाची आहे, त्यांची भूमिका महत्त्वाची आहे, त्यापासून मिळणारी उपयुक्तता महत्त्वाची आहे, उपयोगिता महत्त्वाची आहे, याकडे लोकांचं दुर्लक्ष झाल्यामुळं सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांचं घट मोठ्या प्रमाणावरती होत आहे, त्यांचं संरक्षण संवर्धन होत नाही असं आपल्याला दिसतं. त्याचा परिणाम काय व्हायला लागला आहे? सामुदायिक मालक घटत जाण्याचा, संसाधनाचा ऱ्हास होत चाललेला आहे, आर्थिक नुकसान मोठ्या प्रमाणात होत चाललेलं आहे, साधनांची दुर्मिळता मोठ्या प्रमाणात वाढत चाललेली आहे, पर्यावरणाचा ऱ्हास मोठ्या प्रमाणावरती होत चाललेला आहे, जैवविविधता नष्ट होत चाललेली आहे, विषमता वाढत चाललेली आहे, उत्पन्नाचं साधन आणि वृद्धीचं साधन हे नष्ट होत चाललेलं आहे, आणि एक जीवनाचा आधार उदरनिर्वाहाचं साधन संपत चाललेलं आहे असं आपल्याला दिसतं. मग उपाय काय आपल्याला यातून कसा हा प्रश्न सोडवता येईल? जमिनीची जी मशागत आहे त्यामध्ये बदल करायला पाहिजे, त्याच्यामध्ये शिफ्ट रोटेशन आणायला पाहिजे. त्यामुळं काय होतं की जमीन सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं त्याचं संरक्षण संवर्धन होतं, लोकांना हक्क द्यायला पाहिजे, त्यांनी सवलती द्यायला पाहिजे, त्यातून आपल्याला हे संरक्षण करता येईल. संयुक्त जंगल व्यवस्थापन केलं तर त्यामधून जंगल हे जे सामुदायिक मालकी साधन आहे त्याचं संरक्षण संवर्धन चांगल्या पद्धतीने आपल्याला करता येईल. स्त्रियांचे मंडळ, निसर्ग मंडळ अशी जर केली तर त्यामधून एक संवर्धन संरक्षणासाठी मदत होऊ शकेल. स्थानिक कर स्थानिक सरकार जर लादले तर त्याचा अतिरिक्त वापर, चुकीचा वापर, गैरवापर होणार नाही, आणि त्यामधून सुद्धा ही सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं संरक्षण संवर्धन होईल. त्या समुदायामध्ये, त्या लोकांच्या गटामध्ये सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं वापराच्या संदर्भातली नियमावली ही असायला पाहिजे, आणि नियमावली जर असली तर त्यामुळं काय होईल की सामुदायिक मालकी साधनांचं संरक्षण संवर्धन करण्यामध्ये त्याची मदत होऊ शकेल असं आपल्याला म्हणता येईल. अशा प्रकारे पर्यावरणाच्या अर्थशास्त्राची तोंडओळख करत असताना नैसर्गिक साधनांचा एक प्रकार म्हणून एक घटक म्हणून सामुदायिक मालकी साधनं याचा विचार आपल्याला करणं आवश्यक असतं आणि तो विचार आपण करण्याचा प्रयत्न केला मला वाटतं ते तुम्हाला उपयोगी आणि फायदेशीर ठरेल तसं ते व्हावं अशा प्रकारची अपेक्षा आहे. धन्यवाद.